Free rides are being offered in Manila as the week-long transport gets underway. Our correspondent Izzy Lee joins us on the line for more on this. Izzy, good morning. What do you have for us?
Good morning, Nikki. From today, March 6th to Sunday, March 12th, the local government of Manila will implement Oplan Libreng Sakay in response to the announced strike by transportation groups against the modernization of PUVs. They will deploy 33 vehicles to assist passengers who may be stranded during the transport strike. Libreng Sakay will travel to and from the following routes: Vito Cruz Taft Avenue to Quezon Boulevard, España Boulevard to Welcome Rotonda, Abad Santos Avenue to R. Papa Rizal Avenue, UN Taft Avenue to R. Papa Rizal Avenue, Recto Avenue to SM Santa Mesa, UN Taft Avenue to P. Ocampo Street, Monumento Rizal Avenue to Divisoria, Buendía Taft Avenue to Divisoria, Buendía Taft Avenue to Monumento Rizal Avenue, and Buendía Taft Avenue to Welcome Rotonda. Additionally, electric tricycles will be available for free transport on secondary roads in the city. Mayor Honey Lacuna Pangan personally supervised these vehicles at Cartilla ng Katipunan this morning.
Meron po tayong dineploy na mga kapulisan sa lahat po ng lugar to ensure yung peace and order, and to ensure po na wala pong mangugulo sa mga gustong mga jeep na hindi sumali sa strike. So, siyempre, aalalay din po tayo sa mga katabi nating mga cities. Kasi meron din naman po tayong mga kababayan na from other cities tapos papasok po ng Manila.
The city has also announced asynchronous classes for all public schools at all levels in the city of Manila from Monday, March 6, 2023 to Saturday, March 11. Private schools are encouraged to switch to online classes during this time. This morning, Nikki, we tried to go to different areas in Manila to check the situation. There were still jeepneys flying their route and no stranded passengers as of this moment. Back to you, Nikki.
All right, thanks for that update, Izzy. He says. In other news, Philippine transport routes kick off a week-long transport strike against the planned phase-out of traditional jeepneys in favor of modern electric vehicles. Some 40,000 jeepney and UVU Express drivers are expected to join the strike. Transport groups are calling on government to iron out issues in the jeepney modernization program, including the deadline for the industry consolidation or the mandate that requires drivers and operators to join a cooperative. The Transportation Department has warned of administrative and criminal charges against those who will participate in the strike, including the possible suspension of their franchise. The transport regulators have issued permits to public utility vehicles, allowing them to operate outside of their routes, to assist commuters who will be affected by the strike.
The Philippine National Police is on heightened alert for the week-long strike. The PNP says this means 80% of its personnel will be on standby. Cops will be stationed in public transport terminals and in locations where free rides will be offered to passengers. Among those who are expected to provide free rides is the MMDA or the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority. The agency also lifted the number coding scheme today, March 6th, due to the strike. It says it will assess the situation to see if there's a need to expand the suspension of the scheme on the succeeding days.
Protesters gather at the University of the Philippines in Diliman as part of the week-long nationwide transport strike. Let's get details from our correspondent, Nico Bagsig, who is there live. Nico, go ahead.
Nikki, good morning. The country braces for the week-long transportation strike starting today to Sunday, March 12, as groups protest against what they perceive as the imminent phase-out of traditional jeepneys. Transport groups Manibela, Piston, and Laban TNVS are staging the strike as a response to the implementation of the jeepney modernization program by the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. The transport strike will begin here at UP Diliman and will pass by the LTFRB office at East Avenue in Quezon City for what they call Pusinihan protest. Manibela chairperson Mar Valbuena previously said around 40,000 public utility vehicles in Metro Manila alone would participate in the strike. Meanwhile, over here at Silcoa in Quezon City, there are very few jeepney units spotted, but the passengers are the usual volume every Monday rush hour. Commuters seem to have prepared for the strike as motorcycle hailing apps abound here at Tulcoa to get passengers who have booked a ride. Coloro motorcycles are also here to entice other passengers who are in a rush to go to work and who are still waiting for the free ride by the QCLGU. Bus units are also standing room only. Some commuters are also taking taxis on a carpooling deal where four passengers get to share the ride at a more minimal fare. Right now, Nikki, long queues await the commuters who will take a ride here at Tulcoa and Quezon City waiting for trips bound to Quiapo and Lotan in Manila and Buendia in Makati City. Back to you, Nikki.
All right, thanks for that update, Nico. You stay safe. Let's get another update on the ongoing transport strike and its effect on commuters. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines is monitoring the situation in the southern portion of Metro Manila. Andy, what can you tell us? Good morning.
Hi, Nikki. We've been monitoring the situation here at the Zapote to Alabang Road since 4 a.m. But right now, this is considered the crucial hour because this is when we'll get to see the impact of the transport strike. By now, traditional GP drivers who are vehemently against the government's PUV modernization program have begun their protest action near a mall in Alabang, so they won't be plying the streets anymore. We talked to some jeepney drivers this morning, and even those who aren't necessarily keen on joining the strike say they might be forced to participate if they travel to Alabang. That's why they're also avoiding that route. As a result, some commuters headed that way had to endure quite a lengthy wait before they got to ride.
Kasi po kapag Southland lang, masyadong malayo kung lalakarin. So, kailangan talaga paalabang. So, malayo talaga.
Libo-libo po yung nakaprepossession natin na so far wala pa po tayong dinideploy masyado dahil wala pa nga po tayong nakikita ng mga stranded na pasahero.
Nikki, that statement by MMDA Chairman Artes was made about 2 hours ago. But a while ago, just minutes ago, we already saw one transporter provided by the Las Piñas city government. It was able to onboard a lot of the passengers who were still waiting to ride a jeepney here. So that's already one transporter that we saw. The others that we saw a while ago, commuters didn't actually need to ride them because there were still jeepneys going around.
All right. Andy, were you also able to ask other GP drivers right there on location with you right now what they think about the transport strike?
Nikki, even though some of them don't necessarily want to join the strike because they want to earn, because they want to keep earning a living even for the rest of the week, they say that they feel like they need to. They're compelled to join the protest action because at the end of it all, they're fighting for the same thing, and that's to prevent a jeepney phase out.
All right. On that note, thanks for joining us this morning, Andy. You stay safe.